money. Can he keep the streak alive? He's got six laps to fend off Buddy Kofoid and company as we're back to green in the A main.
It's Tuesday night, which means it's Kyle Larson's night here at the Lucas Oil Chili Bowl. Last night, putting together some really good laps with Justin Grant and the Viroc. How'd the car feel?
Much better than it's been, so I was pleased with that. I was not good in the morning hot lap session, but Paul changed some stuff on Chase and in my car, and we were both much better. So much more confident after last night, but still a different game here today with just circumstance and stuff like that. So start last in my heat race and hopefully pick off a handful of cars and rack up some decent points and just get through that heat race good, and then you can kind of manage your night from there.
Just trying to find a way to go, just keep that car pinned on the bottom. Swanson moves to the outside, that opens the lane. Three wide into corner one, Larson passing two cars in the first turn, trying to settle himself now into the third spot as Hardy goes backwards. So move now Larson into second, or third, excuse me. We go on board with the drone, one of the coolest shots here at the Chili Bowl, as there's Larson in the 0-1, threading the needle. Kyle Larson's got it wound up, going for the lead as we ride on board with the drone, and he makes it look easy. See you later, Kyle Larson in the Flo Racing 01 as he takes the drive down the back straightaway and begins to pull away.
One more time around for the Titan of Tuesdays, Kyle Larson, 6-1 in the qualifier, and assumedly up front for tonight's A main event.
Is the hood coming up or is it just me?
Yeah.
I like the Titan MX. And the top end is really good. Like I exit more square.
That curve lets you rip that curve. Like you're in it.
So I thought you'd run the cushion, like get in and you kind of come off a little bit.
Like come off a little bit. But we offer
back to it.
For every phase of the job,
but when I exit, I exit.
I feel
like a drove the straightest there down the back straightaway. And I'm
getting greater than
I can see the back coming at me. Like I'm watching it from here, I'm watching all that.
You guys are looking
at like by your wall.
We appreciate it. You're driving down here to watch the A main later tonight. And you meet you down here at the end of the
middle. Did you watch my qualifier? Did you watch my last race? How'd the middle work in the first corner?
Terrible.
And you're trying to tell me you're on the middle again?
Finishers to the A main, 3-8 to a Saturday B, 9-14 to a C. That's what's at stake.
Kyle Larson and Buddy Kofoid lead him into three and out of corner number four. Green flag, we go racing.
Money. Can he keep the streak alive? He's got six laps to fend off Buddy Kofoid and company as we're back to green in the A main.
This chess match has just been brilliant. Here comes Kofoid again.
Got him.
Around the top, and he got him down the back straightaway. And he got to the bottom, too. Can he hold it? He bikes it up. He does not. Buddy Kofoid, your new leader, with five to go.
Five fingers in the air from Terry Maddox. Larson's going to throw the haymaker at one and two. Got out of the gas, and that's going to allow Kofoid to scoot away.
Now Larson gets a chance to try to run the top and come back around it, but it's so far around. Get Kofoid, be good down low. Kofoid back to the top of one and two. Slide jump, Larson doesn't complete it. Larson's going to try it just like he did in the Viroc, throwing everything he can, the kitchen sink, at Buddy Kofoid.
He's going to get him right here. He's going to clear this.
Big bomb down to one and two. Larson's got it off the cushion, but Kofoid turns back underneath. Buddy Kofoid holds him to the three and four. Larson back to the top. Larson's
can Kofoid hold off the best in the world? And it's Larson dropping back another spot. Larson lost the spot to Wyndham. Now he's got to scramble to get back into a lock-in position. Wyndham down low. Larson up top with one to go. This is Kofoid's, but this is about the lock-in on the final time around.
Larson, the haymaker to one and two, trying to get the lock-in spot. Wyndham bikes off the cushion, but through three and four, Michael Buddy Kofoid's going to get himself a prelim win here at the Chili Bowl Nationals.
Kofoid knocks off Larson. Larson two, and he's in the show.
Listen, you are going to the Saturday main event, but just talk about that battle between Kofoid, man. It was so good.
Yeah, it was good. He was there the whole race, so it was a fun race. I just made a bad decision on that restart. I thought, you know, the entry was getting so slow, and I felt like if he was anywhere close enough, he could throw a slider on me had I gone straight to the top. So in my mind, I thought maybe if I could hit the bottom for one corner, hit the bottom for a lap, I could get back to doing what I was doing, and just missed it a little bit too much, and he probably got a nailed his corner in one and two and got by and clear into three. And I put together a few good laps up top in three and four, but I think I maybe cleared him once off of two, but I hit the curb really bad that same time and then went down to this next in and got over the cushion. So bummer that I didn't win, but you know, we're still locked in and still giving ourselves a shot on Saturday.
There was nine Chili Bowl starters in this prelim alone from last year. I mean, you got to feel good that you passed all those cars just to get to a lock-in spot, though.
Yeah, I mean, the night went well. I would have liked to have been one spot better, but, I mean, this is definitely the toughest, you know, prelim night of the week. You know, when they stretch them out to however many days it is, they're not as tough as they used to be, but still, I mean, when you rank it against the other nights, it's still the toughest night, so... glad that I was able to, you know, have a good heat, good qualifier, and you know, get locked in the future.
Nice run.
Thank you.